G'day and welcome back to Build Some. And as you can see, we're back on our little building that we did the weatherboard on in a previous video. And in this video, what I want to show you is the process of calculating the actual effective cover of our weatherboards and therefore the lap that we require. What we want to get is our weatherboards equally spaced all the way up the wall, so that our top board is not a very thin board or half a board. It's actually the same width that you see all the way down the wall. So to do that, we need to know the height of our wall, and we need to know what our estimated effective cover is and what our anticipated lap is, or what the manufacturer recommends as a lap. So obviously when we buy the boards, we're going to know how wide they are, and if we read the manufacturer's instructions, we should find out what they recommend as the lap. So in this case, I've got a 230mm board and the manufacturer recommends a 25mm lap, so therefore my effective cover is 205mm. So to work out how many boards I need in the wall, if I take the height of the wall and divide that by my estimated effective cover, it tells me in this case my wall's 2.4, my estimated effective cover is 205mm, so I need 11.707 boards. Obviously not really going to work, we want an even number of boards, so I'm going to round that up to 12 boards. So I need 12 boards, and in this case the building's 3.2 metres long, so I need 12 boards at 3.2 metres. Okay, so we know we need 12 boards, but I need to get them on the wall evenly. So my anticipated lap of 25mm is not going to work. I have to work a new lap out and therefore a new effective cover. So my actual effective cover is going to be the height of the wall divided by the number of boards. So my wall is 2.4 high. My number of boards I'm going to use is 12. So that means that I'm going to have an effective cover of 200mm. So with my original board being 230mm, if I take away 200mm off that, that means that when I set up for my wall, my lap, or the lap of each board, is going to be 30mm. So when I come to put up my board, then when I lap the second board over, it has to be 30mm down on the first one, and all of them have to be 30mm down, and that means I see 20mm of each board. When we get to the top, we'd actually have to rip 30mm off the top of that board to get it to fit. And what you can do, if you do that first, you can rip that 30mm off, and then you can put it back down on the bottom here as your kicker strip. So if you think ahead, you can save yourself a bit of waste, and you can cut that strip off first, nail it on there as a kicker strip, and then use the board last to fill in that part of the last board on the wall. So that's how we calculate the even spacing or the even lap of our boards on a weatherboard plank wall.